Intuit is now weaponizing race in an effort to dissuade Americans from supporting the IRS launching a free tax filing system. Now, they haven't done it yet. It's been in the works for quite some time, but this is a big deal because it costs money to file your taxes. It can get real expensive. Yeah. So having a free option available to people is wonderful news. Now, why is Intuit trying to destroy this? Well, Intuit is the parent company for TurboTax, and they stand to lose some business if there's a genuine free option provided by the IRS. And as a result, they're claiming that the free service would harm Black Americans. What? I mean, it is insane. So we'll get to their reasoning in a moment. But before we get to the specious claims, let's back up for a little bit of context, okay? So the IRS announced back in May that they're developing this online service that would let Americans directly file their taxes for free. Now, unfortunately, as it stands, we don't know when the service is going to officially launch and be available to everyone. It's currently in the testing phase, so it's unknown when it'll be available. But we also don't know if it's going to be available for everyone. Like, I'm hoping this isn't gonna be some weird means tested thing. I think it should be available to every individual in the United States. But that's what we know and don't know about it so far. Now, Intuit has opposed such proposals, not just now, for a long time. They have a long history of this. For a decade, proposals have sought to create IRS tax software or a return free tax system. All were stopped, reads a confidential 2007 PowerPoint presentation from an Intuit board of directors meeting. And because of Intuit's efforts, Americans still have to shell out some pretty serious cash to file their taxes in some cases. So look, it really depends on what your work situation is, whether you're a W-2 employee or if you're a freelance employee. The more complicated your taxes are, the more expensive it is to file. However, you know, according to the IRS, on average, Americans spend 13 hours and $250 every year to file their taxes. So this is a great effort to try to save Americans some time and money. Now, these days it seems that Intuit is getting pieces published in the media to basically regurgitate their nonsense talking points. And as ProPublica reported, they did a great investigation into this. They write that op-eds and stories that parrot Intuit's talking points have appeared in at least 20 newspapers and other publications across the country. So what talking points exactly? Let's get into it. IRS free tax service could further harm Blacks is how the Defender, a Black paper in Houston, put it in a June headline. The piece cited unnamed industry experts as raising the concern, but quoted only one person by name, Intuit's spokesperson, Derek Plummer. That same month, the publication called Black Enterprise published a similar piece which cited industry skeptics, but only quoted Derek Plummer, the only person who was quoted in this piece, the second piece we're talking about. But the rabbit hole gets even deeper, okay? Because the disinformation campaign is also linked to No Labels. You remember them? So No Labels is that massive organization that raised tens of millions of dollars from, you know, billionaires in the country for the likely purpose of launching a corporate friendly third party candidate to challenge President Joe Biden. Now, Benjamin Chavis is the former executive director of the NAACP, and he wrote the highest profile Intuit friendly op-ed recently. Okay, so he is now the national co-chair of No Labels. And so how are these schools basically trying to convince Black Americans that a free tax filing system is gonna hurt them in some way? I'll give you a little taste. So earlier this year, a study by a team of academic and government researchers found that the IRS audited Black taxpayers between 3 and 5 times the rate of other taxpayers. As a result, an Intuit blog post argued having the IRS prepare the taxes of Black taxpayers would likely increase these inequities. Chavis more timidly offered that it may increase income inequality. Now look, there might be methodology issues with how that study was done, right? But It's not the IRS filing taxes on behalf of anyone. It's just providing a free option to file your taxes. So, I mean, if you file your taxes with someone else and you pay for it, and there's anything that seems a little fishy for the IRS, they're gonna audit you, right? If you lie as you're filing taxes in, you know, the IRS system, yeah, they're gonna audit you. That's the way it works. But the idea that simply offering a free option is going to somehow victimize black people as they file their taxes is laughable to say the least. And according to ProPublica, there are a few problems with the assertion. The study asserted that audits of people who claim the earned income tax credit were actually the main source of racial inequality. For decades, the IRS has disproportionately audited EITC claimants because of pressure from Republicans in Congress, as well as laws that require a special focus on improper payments. Furthermore, the IRS has for some time now disproportionately targeted lower income Americans, in which unfortunately black people are overrepresented because they lack the resources to properly audit wealthy people. Wealthy people have far more complicated taxes. It takes more resources to audit them. And as a result, like the Republican Party has been defunding the IRS. They actually succeeded in another round of taking some of the resources that were allocated by Democrats away from the IRS. And what that does is it cripples the IRS from being able to do its job and audit the wealthy people who get away with dodging their taxes and cheating on their taxes when they file every year. And so, look, you don't even have to take it from us. I think most people who watch this show know that ProPublica is a fantastic investigative outlet. And here's an excerpt from the study itself. So because EITC audit selection is largely automated, and because the IRS does not observe race, the status quo racial audit disparity is unlikely to be driven by disparate treatment of black and non-black taxpayers. That is from the study itself. So Intuit took that, twisted it, and tried to use it against the IRS, putting out a free service.
Yeah, systems of all kinds, whether they're public or private, I mean, we'll get into the private part of it in a moment, always tend to have discriminatory outcomes based on who in our population is best equipped to monetize or profit or perhaps circumvent that system. So elites, hyper wealthy folks, or just wealthier folks more generally, meaning non-working class or maybe middle class people, are able to park their money in all sorts of fancy little derivatives, or park them in the Cayman Islands or whatever you want, and create extremely complex portfolios of income and investment to basically evade IRS audit and pay for fancy accountants who can help them hide their money accordingly. So a public system and a good service trying to make, you know, tax filing free for everybody will have outcomes that can, that could be asymmetric in the wider population. But that's simply because power is unequally distributed in our society, in our world. So think about what happens then if you add onto it a private option where you have to pay for it, right? Don't you think that that would even more so discriminate against working class or working poor people who, you know, tend to be disproportionately people of color in many cases, right? And so think about who the pawns are, though, amidst all this. It's obviously the working class, but the fact it's actually it's insulting to black people that they're set up as a pawn in all of this charade, you know?
Because it's taking a concern that the black community has and weaponizing that concern against them. And I've seen that happen so many times. I mean, look, in this case, we're talking about black Americans, but think about Senator Bob Menendez, who's now facing charges for illegal corruption and decided to use his identity as a Cuban American to make himself out to be some sort of victim, someone who's being targeted because of his heritage, which is laughable. And by the way, this is the second time he's facing charges for illegal corruption in a totally separate case. And so, like, I've seen bad faith actors weaponize race or identity in order to skirt responsibility. I've seen businesses use social justice rhetoric in order to prop up their own profit motives and business practices. I think this is a great example of Intuit doing just that in order to, you know, scare Black Americans from something that could actually be beneficial to them and to everybody.
Right? I mean, there's plenty of greenwashing and diversity, yeah, equity, inclusion washing,
yes,
that's out there.
Yes. Can you talk about that a little more? I think really important.
Sure. Yeah. Yeah. So because I look at kind of how inequalities of different forms are baked into systems that people treat as neutral and that are, you know, designed to be not transparent and certainly not accountable or governed by the public, by the demos. We can sort of see how when these systems fail in particular ways, how that can create this opportunity for various corporations, mm-hmm, and corporate actors to say, well, we're actually caring a little bit about diversity in this and this way. And it's very consistent with what you see corporations do also with corporate social responsibility or little foundations that they set up. It's a sort of, it's a back patting kind of,
yes,
exercise.
Yes.
It's scratching one another. You know what? And in the meantime, there are practices at all costs are to take out anything that's public, cheat the tax code, and even write bills and policies that immunize them from any amount of control or oversight, right?
Yep.
So instead, we could ask a very interesting question just in relation to this Intuit example. What would it take to design a system that is run by the IRS that first and foremost starts with working poor and working class people and elevates them and supports them so that the system in a neutral sense doesn't have unequal outcomes, right? What would it take to design such a system, including, you know, supporting consumers or citizens who file their taxes so that everybody could be lifted up? And whenever, yes, you design systems for the wider public, you always start by designing it for those most at the margins. Because if you can design things that really work for and support people at the margins, you can actually support everybody.
Yes.
Right? So that would be the exact opposite of this. But what Intuit is doing is using a bunch of garbage critique to basically figure out a way to try to just hoard more money. But these are sociopathic systems that are not just the technological or the business system. It's a sociopathic institution, a private corporation, which at all costs, no matter what, wants to expand its profitability or its valuation.
That's basically also exploiting the flaws in our media.
Oh, for
and,
sure.
And using the media to essentially further its propaganda, which only helps to serve them and only leads to less options for you if there's no free option through the IRS and more profits for them. So that's what this is really about. And so whenever you come across op-eds, whenever you come across a piece that really has this declarative perspective that something is causing harm to a community, just do a little more digging and try to figure out if it's a sponsored post. There's some sponsored content on a lot of these news sites and make sure that you know who's really behind the publishing of these pieces, because it just makes me sick to my stomach to know that there are all these articles out there that only serve to mislead the general public. And I'll do my best to debunk as many of them as we can on this show, but I'm only one person. And so hopefully we're giving you guys some of the tools to be able to do some of that yourself. Like, media literacy in today's, you know, media market is just so critical because it's so easy to be misled. I should know, I've experienced that myself.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below, because that makes you a member, and members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want, no corporate media influence, and that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button, become one of the Young Turks.